Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14 Beta 7 has been out to both developers, and iOS 14 Public Beta 7 came out the same day, just a little bit later. And so I've been using it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. I also have it on the iPhone 11 here, as well as the iPhone 6S Plus and the 2020 iPad Pro 12.9. Now, I've primarily been using it on the iPad and my iPhone, so let's go ahead and talk about a couple new things that I missed in the initial What's New video. Later, we'll talk about bugs, things they fixed, and then the YouTube community poll and how it's been for you. Now, the first thing is a couple small features. Some people are seeing this dock turn a black color or change a darker color. Now, I'm on dark mode right now, so you'll see that it's going to be a little bit darker. If I go back to light mode, go back to dark, it will darken, and that's pretty normal, but some people are seeing it go even darker than that. So Apple could continually be tweaking this, making it a little bit darker, maybe more transparent. It's hard to say, but we'll see once the final version comes out. Now, another small change, they keep changing the page dots at the bottom. So you can see the page dots here. If I bring in iOS 14 beta 6 here on the iPhone XR, you can see the page dot spacing continually changes. It's as though they keep moving it up and then back down. Now it's back up. Some of the spacing around the dots has actually changed. So it's a little bit different than it was before. Not a huge difference, but it's a little bit different. Also, some people on Reddit are seeing some interesting Siri suggestions. Now, some people were able to clear it. I wasn't able to find that, but you can see this user on Reddit here said, making a lot of phone calls, this mom person is very popular. So Siri is telling them that, hey, you're making a lot of calls to this specific person, and it's telling you your most popular caller. So that's pretty interesting. I thought it was an interesting find. And some people are able to actually clear Siri suggestions. I wasn't able to find this, a new UI to sort of clear this. So maybe if we had Siri suggestions for Apple, I can't clear any of those. So some people are seeing that, I'm not. However, there's an interesting trick in Safari that isn't new to this particular version, but is a new UI compared to before. So if you hold the back button, you'll see it gives you all of the recent websites you've been to. So that's nothing new, but they changed the UI. This used to be full page. Now it's just a small snippet there. So it's just a small little change. I didn't mention in previous videos, so I thought I'd mention it here. Now there's a couple things that a few people have mentioned, but I haven't been able to see myself. For example, if we go into mail, in mail, some people are saying that when they go to select a bunch of emails at once, it has a different color for them. This has always been gray for me. In fact, let me go over to beta 6 and you'll see on the left with beta 6, it looks the same for me, but some were saying the blue color has gone away. I'm still seeing it, so it's still there for me. Now, as far as this particular update, there is one other thing that keeps changing for a lot of people, and that is the weather widget. It keeps changing from this style to a style that's a little bit more vertical. Now, some people were saying that this changes based off of time of day and everything else. I haven't been able to correlate it to a time of day. So dark mode, night, morning, light mode, it didn't seem to matter. Sometimes it looks like this, other times it's more vertical. If you've figured out exactly why it's doing that, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. So there aren't a ton of other features in here, but there is some good news as far as bugs. Now, a few people were saying that they were able to see 4K YouTube videos that weren't able to see it before. That's actually controlled by YouTube. So I'm seeing them on my iPhone 11 Pro Max and my iPad Pro. So those 4K videos are there and they should be playing just fine. So some people are seeing them. Let me check on the iPhone 11 to see if I have it there, even though this is not a 2160 or 4K screen. Now you can see on my iPhone 11 that I have up to 1080p. So I don't have 2160p or 4K, and that's because the screen doesn't go up to that resolution. However, some people with lower resolution screens are seeing that option. So whether or not this sticks once the final version comes out is hard to say, but I keep getting questions about that. So it's controlled completely by YouTube. If you want to try it, close out the app, try it again and see if it shows up for you. Now, a good thing is AirDrop seems to be working properly across all my devices now. So oftentimes I'd have to reboot my phone to get it to work properly. And then also tapping the apps in the app list seem to work properly now. So if we go into maybe home, it opens quickly. Even if you tap to the left of it, it seems to be working again. So I swiped off of it there. So as long as you get within the app, it seems to respond much better than it did on the previous version. So that's a really good sign. Now, overall, it's been pretty stable, and those were the only bug fixes I actually saw, but quite a few other bugs still exist. I have seen YouTube crash a few times on my phone and mostly on the iPad. So on the iPad, the experience has been mostly stable with the exception of YouTube crashing or locking up. So I've seen that a couple times. And then also I've got this weird bug that if I'm using split view with multiple applications, and then I use the Magic Keyboard, sometimes the keyboard itself won't work. I can use the keyboard on screen and the trackpad on the Magic Keyboard, but not the trackpad and keyboard. So it's a weird bug I've encountered. I've seen it a few times. I'm not sure what's causing it, but it seems to happen more in split view than anything else. Otherwise, the experience on the iPad has been rock solid for me. In fact, most of the time, you wouldn't know that it's a beta at all. However, on the iPhone, like I said, there's still a couple issues. So for example, Twitter is frozen on me a couple times. Also YouTube, like I said. And also some people are seeing in wallpaper where it's blurring the wallpaper in the background. I'm not seeing this. It's not blurring it weird, but some people are seeing it when they go into wallpaper. One will be very blurry. The other one won't. It'll be super blurred on one side and not the other. And we haven't seen a new wallpaper picker like some people were saying we were going to see. So maybe it has something to do with that, but I haven't seen it malfunction personally, but I know a lot of people are. Now, also some people are reporting that when you go to the lock screen and you press and hold on the camera and it opens up, some people are saying it's super laggy and not responding properly or working properly. I personally have not seen that, but quite a few people have messaged me about that. Also, speaking of the camera, on some of the older devices, mirroring the front camera is not there. So mirroring the front display. So let's go here. We'll go to our camera app here. And you'll see mirror front camera. Some people are saying it's disappeared on the older versions of iPhones or the older iPhones. It seems to be present in my devices, although let's go down to front camera here, wherever that is. There we go. And you'll see mirror front camera is there. So it just depends on the device you have. If you're on an older phone, like an iPhone 6S Plus, hopefully they'll bring it back. There's no reason for it to go away. Maybe they just had some bugs with it in this particular update, but we'll check for it once it comes back and hopefully it'll be there. Now, also Pokemon Go does not work on this still. So quite a few people are saying that it won't work. I actually installed it. It just won't even open. So it probably has something to do with the camera and augmented reality, something to do with the new code. Once Pokemon Go updates that app, it should work. But if you're playing Call of Duty Mobile, well, that seems to work just fine. I've been playing it, not on this, but I've actually been playing it on the iPad quite a bit. And then also, people on the iPad are saying they're seeing a weird bug. I've not experienced this, but some people are seeing some of the native apps sort of shrink their icons to a point where they look small compared to the other ones, maybe half size, and then the screen is flashing. I'm not experiencing this on this latest iPad, and I haven't seen it on the iPad Air 2, so hopefully it's not showing up for most of you, but a couple people have complained about that. Now, while I was making this video, someone pointed out on the Telegram channel, I have a Zolotech Telegram channel and Discord linked in the description, but someone pointed out a quick way to clear notifications that I hadn't seen before. I thought it was pretty interesting. His name is Boss, so if you scroll down, press and hold on the X to clear the notifications, tap clear, it actually clears them all. So you could have 100 in there. It will clear them all. It seems to work every time. I tried it on the iPhone 11 and it cleared them all right out. So I thought that was pretty interesting. It's a nice little tip. Now, I haven't been having any issues with performance. I haven't had any issues with widgets personally. However, people do keep asking me, when are we going to see a new widget from, say, a third party? And that actually depends on when someone creates the app. They actually have to update that particular part of the app with a new widget. Now, unfortunately, we won't see those until the final release, but you can see I have a Wikipedia widget. So when the third party apps update, or you're using beta updates, those widgets will show up and then you can use them on your phone. So you'll see those widgets in the future. It's kind of interesting. They just have photos of the day, but if you install them using Test Flight, if you want to be a beta tester, you can try out multiple apps that people are offering, and then you'll see those third-party widgets. Of course, it's a beta, so those apps could be unstable, and I thought that was interesting. So I can't wait until iOS 14 is released so we see all of those widgets. And speaking of when iOS 14 is released, it seems like there's going to be an event or some sort of notification or mention of some new products on this Tuesday. So we may see that. That seems to be from a fairly reliable source, not just John Prosser, but others are saying this at this point. And so we'll probably see that. And John Prosser has never been wrong about a date. So we'll probably see it there, but we should see iOS 14 released probably in a few weeks. In fact, I would think we'll see iOS 14 beta 8 this week. I think we're on a weekly cycle, like I said before, and I would expect it sometime in the middle of this coming week. That could be Tuesday, could be Wednesday, or Thursday again, and then maybe a GM the following week and a final release the week of the 21st. And the reason, or the week of the 20th. And the reason I say that is because in the past, that's sort of the week they released iOS 14. Now, they could push that back based on what they're going to do and based on the delay we had with iOS 14 beta 1, but expect at least, I think, another beta, then the GM, then a final. So a few weeks away. And of course, I'll keep you updated as soon as I know more as far as that goes. But I would expect a beta this coming week. Of course, Apple could change it up. It could be a couple weeks again, but hopefully we see some updates. Now let's take a look at my overall battery life on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. And my battery health is still at 96%. And this can vary depending on your phone, how you charge it and use it. And like I said before, the updates don't affect battery health. They're just simply rechecking the battery. So all batteries degrade, unfortunately, until someone develops a better battery. Android phones, cars, everything using batteries will degrade over time. Now, my battery life on the first day I installed it was actually okay. 5 hours and 8 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 7 minutes of screen off time, using about 65% of my battery. Now, I'm still getting about 9 or 10 hours of screen on time on this phone. However, that's not the 10 or 12 hours I was getting before. I'm getting a lot of screen off time, playing music and things like that. But you'll see yesterday wasn't that great at all. 2 hours and 42 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 38 minutes of screen off time. And I used about 50% of my battery. So it really varies from day to day. Depending on what day it is, what device I'm using, it's going to vary. But most people are saying it's better. There are some that are experiencing worse battery life. But if it's bad after the first day or two, maybe try rebooting it. Otherwise, it should be fine. Just give it a couple days to sort of stabilize and make sure you're not running any apps in the background that are causing that sort of drain. There may be something running, and of course, you can just check that down here. Now, based off the YouTube community poll, here are all the issues that people were mentioning. So 85 people mentioned battery. Now, this could be good or bad. Most people are actually saying it's much better than earlier betas. A few people are having their phone heat up and it getting a little bit hot. And then a few people are having issues with mail, but connectivity and general, only one person mentioned Wi-Fi, a separate person mentioned LTE, and another mentioned problems with the Bluetooth. That's out of hundreds of people. So that's a pretty good sign that this is fairly stable. Now, should you update or install iOS 14 beta 7? I would say you should absolutely install iOS 14 beta 7 if you're a beta tester. Since this particular version is getting later and later, it's getting more and more stable. And of course, Apple uses that feedback if you're having a major problem to actually resolve issues. So you want to make sure you report that in your feedback app to Apple, and then they'll prioritize it based on issues that you're having. So hopefully they'll get the major issues fixed and then they'll work on the smaller bugs. And I think they're getting really close to a final release. Now, other than that, here are all of the different devices you've been using. So that's based off the community poll of people that said that. And let's take a look at the poll itself. Also, RAM management has been pretty good. When I opened this up, it had been open for quite some time and it was still on this page. It didn't reload YouTube. So most people are not having issues with RAM management. In fact, zero people mentioned it at the time of collecting the data for this video. Now you can see here, there are 7,500 votes or 7.5K votes based on what you've done so far today. And then there are 213 comments. Now, 41% of you have said that it's great. Only 3% are saying it's terrible. 10% are having bugs. And then 46% of you are on 13.7 or older. That's usually pretty typical that almost 50% are on public versions and a few people are taking a risk with the beta. I would say it's not very risky at this point, but you still could have issues. Now, as far as the comments, let's take a look at some of them. Let me sort them and we'll take a closer look. Now, the first one from Justin says, I use my iPhone XR on iOS 14 beta 7, but when I go into the NASCAR app, it kicks me out almost all the time. And that's very similar to what you get with Pokemon Go. It seems to be doing the same thing. Mark said iPhone 10, and it's pretty rough at times. iMessage closes on its own, keyboard disappears in the middle of typing, and battery life isn't very good. Veteran Beck says running great on iPhone 8 Plus, some apps hang a bit, but nothing major. Larry Bogg says seems to be good so far, just a couple of issues. Using on my iPhone 7 Plus and my iPad Pro 2020, will install it on my daily driver iPhone 11 this weekend. Ashley Hodson said 11 Pro Max and it's running smoothly for me. Battery is good. Ronald Shirk said I have a bug in the control center on iPhone 11 Pro Max for home favorites, 5 blank toggles. Does anyone have this in beta 7? And yes, I have a blank space again. It comes and goes. It's kind of interesting. Sometimes it's there, sometimes it's not. So it's kind of strange how that keeps coming back. The Tree Overlord says on iPhone XS and going great, backtap has gotten worse and barely ever works anymore. I saw a couple people say that. I forgot to mention it, that the backtap feature only works occasionally. So hopefully that's working. Israel Jesus says, thank God they fixed my XS Max smart battery case issue. What an annoying issue that, or annoying week that was. So with beta 6, the smart battery case wasn't working and it seems to be working again. Stephen McCoyle said, still no default apps, just got on the beta and was looking forward to it. So the feature is technically there, but the app developer has to meet a couple criteria in order for that to work. So I wouldn't expect to see that feature actually work properly until iOS 14 is released to the public. So a Mail developer or Mail app developer, for example, has to flag and add a couple APIs into their code in order for that to work properly. So again, don't expect that until the final release. Kaza Ralph says, I apologize if I said that wrong, having overheating issues since beta 4 and still persisting in beta 7 on my iPhone XS. Very disappointed and sad with the beta overall. Daniel Spark says, using it on my iPhone XS Max and the battery life is garbage. Worst battery in all iOS 14 betas. Jeremy DeBose says, Pro Max and iPad Pro, really great performance so far. Battery life seems better. Scribble on iPad is still weird. I'm not even in the text field on some apps and then it goes automatically into Scribble mode. Pickaboo says, I'm using the iPhone XS and there seems to be a significant improvement in battery life, and the AirPods text to error message bug has now been fixed. The update has been really smooth for me, the best beta so far. Dave Cormack says, getting more solid on the iPhone 8 Plus. Jeffrey Venner said, iPhone 11, great battery, smooth scrolling, good performance, widgets working well, like new, wallpaper options. And then Joseph Mignone said, hopefully I said that right, I love it and it works great on my iPhone 11 Pro Max and love your videos. And thank you very much. Now, iOS 14 beta 7 doesn't really have much more in it. We're getting closer to that final GM or Golden Master version. So expect iOS 14 beta 8 this coming week, like I said, a GM later on, and then the final release within a few weeks. Now, iOS 12 actually had 12 betas, so it could vary depending on what Apple decides to do, but hopefully we'll see it sooner rather than later. And of course, if there's new updates and news and everything, I cover that on Mondays, and then if we have anything new on Tuesday, of course, I'll keep you informed there as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.